Hey guys, welcome back to Naughty Threats. In case you're watching this channel for the first time, do subscribe and don't forget to hit the bell icon to get all the future updates. In today's video, we learn how to work this kind of a slanting arch design. So the bead is the highlight of this particular design. I have used lot of beads because sari has a lot of zari. So the complete sari has this kind of zari work. So that's the reason I thought I'll use more beads, and you can always replace these set of beads with a tassel if you want. Now the way I have designed this does not have any room for tassels, but if you want, you can replace this part with tassels. So it's a very easy and interesting pattern, so watch the video till the end and do let me know how you like it. Now let's get started. I'm using 6 strands of silk thread, some metal beads in 3mm size like this, and my regular crochet hook number 10. So I'm going to start off by fixing the knot. Since the body of the sari is green color, I'm using this pink because it's going to be like a one step design. So here I'll fix my knot. And then I'm going to add some beads. So after I push each bead, I'm going to lock it with single crochet. So I will be adding 2 more beads in the same way. So after adding 3 beads, I will be working 4 chains, and just check wherever it reaches and then fix it using a single crochet. Then continue with 3 chains, which is actually counted as 1 double crochet, and then I will start working my double crochet stitches in this loop of 4 chains. So this is 1, two, three, four, five. Seven. So the first 2 chains that I worked also counts as a stitch, plus 7 stitches is what I have worked. So in total I have 8 double crochets here. So now I will just check where it reaches and I'm going to fix it using a single crochet, after which I'm going to work chains. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. After 7 chains, I'm going to turn and fix it in the last stitch here. Again, I will be working 1 single crochet to fix it. I will chain 1 and turn the sari again. Now in this loop, I will be adding beads. So I'll slide 1 bead and lock it using a single crochet. So one by one I'll add bead. I think easily around 6 to 7 beads can be worked here. So I've added 6 beads. So after adding 6 beads here, just check wherever it reaches, work one single crochet to fix it. So this design gets done in single step. So in the next step, we will just add some beads here. So now I'm going to continue with 3 beads. So after each bead, I'll be working a single crochet. And then 4 chains. 4 chains and single crochet, and then 3 chains, which is counted as 1 double crochet, and 7 double crochets in this chain gap. So I have my 7 stitches, including the 3 chains that I worked in the beginning, it sums up to 8 stitches. Now I'll fix it using a single crochet and then work 7 chains. After 7 chains, I'm going to work a single crochet, turn the fabric and work single crochet in the last stitch here. Chain 1, turn, and then in this loop we'll add 6 beads. So this is how the design will continue throughout the sari. Now in case if you want to give any color variations in this design, you can change the color after you finish the desired number of arches like this. After working this step, we will knot the thread and trim off the thread. In the next step, we'll add beads so that it forms like a triangle. Now this step is completely optional. If you don't want, you can skip this step. However, adding this will make the design look more nice. I mean, if you can see the difference. So we'll see how to do that. We will have to hand stitch this. So I have taken the matching color cotton thread. I have inserted two strands in the needle and made it four, and I have placed a knot. So I'm going to go in here, right below the first bead, and then get the needle into the first bead. So once you have the needle in that bead, we'll take three beads. And then pass the needle in the third bead. We are not doing anything with the second one. So in the third bead, you'll have to pass the needle like this. So once you do that, it will automatically look like a triangle like this. So don't pull it too tight. So give it enough easiness, and then we have this single crochet after the bead. I'm going to go in and knot it. So you will have to knot after each step. Here is the finished look. I have worked the complete sari in just single color because there is more of green. I didn't want to use green, like already mentioned, but you always have an option to change color after every 5 or 6 slanting arches. So that way you will be dividing and using more colors. So do let me know in the comment section how you like this design, and in case if you have not joined our crochet club group on Facebook, do join and follow us on Facebook. So I guess that's all in today's video. In case you have any requests, do WhatsApp me the images and I'll try to shoot videos on that. And don't forget to check out my blog naughtythreads.net and subscribe to my vlog channel Kanika Reddy Vlogs. So I shall see you guys soon. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.